During autumn 2021, Steam Incorporated, in conjunction with Pounamu Travel, ran the Great Southern Train Tour, running along the South Island main trunk from Picton down to Invercargill behind steam and vintage diesel locomotives. The first day of the tour was steam hauled from Picton to Kaikoura behind AB608 Passchendaele, which ran empty to Blenheim, where the tour group would board the train for their journey south. Climbing up the 1-37 gradient from Picton to elevation. Into Blenheim to pick up the passengers. Nearing the top of the climb, through the Dashwood Pass. Climbing into Seddon before heading downhill to Lake Grasmere. approaching Whorinui, where the main north line meets the Pacific Ocean. The train stopped for 2 hours, whilst the passengers had a lunch stop at the store. Whilst the passengers enjoyed their lunch, the Steam Incorporated crew serviced and watered 608 for the next stage of its journey ahead. Departing Perikawa, this is the first time that AV608 has been south of here since its centennial South Island tour in 2015. Exiting the last of the Blue Duck tunnels. Locals came out to admire the steam locomotive before shunting to the yard and placing diesel locomotives DA's 1431 and 1410 at the head. The next day, Steam Incorporated's locomotives are prepared in Kaikoura for their day's duties. Diesel power will now take charge for the run south to Invercargill, with DA's 1431 and 1410, whilst AB608 will run light engine back to Picton to enter first. Prior to departure, the train was shifted to the station platform, with AB608 at the rear. The passenger consist awaits the tour group to board before both trains will split their ways. DA1410 was part of the Phase 1 batch of DA locomotives manufactured by General Motors Diesel Limited, Canada, in 1955. 1431 was later part of the Phase 2 batch of DA locomotives designed by General Motors, then manufactured by Clyde Engineering in New South Wales, Australia, in 1957. Departure from Kaikoura and onwards to Christchurch. South of Kaikoura travels through many tunnels along the coastline while sharing the narrow corridor with State Highway 1. Heading inland through Hundalee. Heading alongside the Hurunui River near Effleton. Crossing the Waipara River. Nearing the town of Kaipoi. Heading through Riccarton on the final stretch into Christchurch's Addington Railway Station. Upon arrival, DA 1431 ran around the train and took the empty carriages to the Waltham car yard with 1410 on the rear. After staying in Christchurch for two nights, the DAs were back in action, heading to Rolleston to pick up the tour group for the run south to Oamaru. An express departure from Rolleston. The main south line from Christchurch to Oamaru travels through many rural communities and across large rivers along the Canterbury Plains. Passing through Timwell, just south of Ashburton. Approaching Caroline Bay. At Timaru, a lunch stop was made at the station cafe, whilst the Middleton locomotive engineers handed over to the Dunedin crew. Heading beside the Pacific Ocean at Normanby. getting away from Stutto. Crossing the Waitaki River. Stopover. Once the passengers have boarded their coaches, the train was propelled over to the yard for stabling overnight. Another day begins as DA's 1431 and 1410 are fired up for the run south to Dunedin. Today, locals of Oamaru will ride the train to Palmerston, where they will return by coach. From there, the tour group meets up at the train once again for the run into the lead of the city. Climbing out of Oamaru at the Wairaka Bank. Downhill to Wainakarua and cruising along at Kaitiki Beach. Thank you. Arrival at Palmerston to unload the locals and board the tour group for the next stage of the journey. Climbing the grade at Toomai. Crossing the Wakawaiti River at Kiritane before the long steep climb from Merton to Seacliff. Heading through Warrington down to sea level at Waitete before climbing again over the Perikanui Hill. Arrival at Dunedin's grand 115-year-old railway station, a very popular tourist attraction in the city. An overnight stop is made before the run to the deep south of Invercargill the next day. This will be the first time that the DA class have ventured this far south on the rail network. The steam and crew for the southbound leg of the tour. Climbing past the Hillside Railway workshops after a midday departure from Dunedin. Cruising past Lake Waihola. Crossing the Clutha River in Balclutha. Thank you. cutting across the barrier between Otago and Southland. Final stretch into Invercargill. Invercargill, the most southern point of the rail tour, has reached. The tour group will now leave the train and travel by coach up the western side of the South Island to Te Anau, Queenstown and the West Coast. In the meantime, the train will stable for 2 nights before heading back north with the next group of passengers booked for the tour.